everyone, welcome back to another video. In today's video, we are diving into Evernote. We're gonna show you my full setup. Hopefully it will be a nice overview of how I use Evernote in my daily routine. It's been like a year and a half since I actually did a video on it last, so hopefully it'll be a nice refresh and also a taster for those who didn't know about it. Anyway guys, if you like this video, hit that like button and leave a comment on some of the tips that you have about Evernote. Without further ado, let's dive in. Hello everyone and welcome to the Evernote setup video. In today's video, what I'm going to be doing with you guys is going over my own personal Evernote account. Now, for those who saw my previous Evernote setup, it was when I was in high school. So a pretty long time ago, but I pretty much have the same setup. Now, just before we get started, I will be demoing this on Mac. And as you may notice, I've also got a little bit of a high contrast running. So this isn't a UI tweak by Evernote. This is my own modifications on accessibilities on Mac, just to make you aware. So here we are. This is my Evernote account. And as you can see, it's pretty simple. Well, if you're someone that knows my setup already, you'll know that I use notebooks quite avidly. Now you see I've got these four stacks of notebooks, and this is a Tiago Forte technique. I've already discussed this quite a lot on channel, and one thing that I'm pretty bad at recently is updating this. So the concept is behind here is projects are between 1 to 12 months long, and they get stored inside of projects. So for example, right now I actually have pretty much everything in there that, like certain projects that I'm working on that I know are going to be temporary to some extent. I also have areas. So areas is a place where I store anything from 1 to 3 years long in there. And at the moment, I've actually got wedding in there, a couple of major projects at YouTube I know is going to be more than a year, hopefully. And number three, I've got resources. So these are like templates, financial information, health information that I need access to, but not all the time, if that makes sense. And then finally, archives, where basically projects and areas come to mind. So to some extent, this hasn't been dramatically changed. I'm using inbox much more often to store items temporarily to sort later. So it essentially works like an email inbox does. Now, I'm also using shortcuts on the left-hand side. I've talked about shortcuts a couple of times, but I'm actually using them more often for project notes that are quite important. So for example, I am filming a Notion Skillshare class very soon to demonstrate the Notion functionality and the brilliance of the resource. And I've got it as a pinned note up here. So you can now see that there. So it's very easy to access. I've always had my traditional useful information there, but I also have like the Team Tools editorial calendar that I sort of paused and I'm looking to re-engage with. So it's actually a neat way to access all of that information. I also have the guest calendar and collab there, calendar, because it's all accessible, as well as the pinned inbox as well. So all of the useful information I'm working on currently is available there. Now, I'm a big user of this recent notes area inside of Evernote. So you may see the recent notes is basically your top five notes. But for me, it actually is a good place to pop back into different items and find them. And of course, I use that quite regularly. One thing I would say is that my tag use is pretty much non-existent. I still use tags occasionally to tag things like agendas, things like meetings, but it really isn't any more structured than it ever has been. I did have a lot of good advice from Enrico Nala, who you guys know, who has been on the channel before a couple of times. I actually need to ping Enrico a message. But he put up a brilliant sort of structure on how to set up tags. So I'll include that in the description below. But I just haven't been using them really at all, mainly because they haven't served as much benefit as I think I should be using to some extent. Now, the one thing I have been using a little more often is reminders, and also another feature which I'll demonstrate in a minute. I've been using reminders quite a lot because they are obviously a pinning functionality to the top of your notebooks. So for example, here I had my Tools They Use pin, and that was actually from last June, but it took me a fair amount of time to deliver that one, right guys?
But it's a good, like, as in it's a good accessibility to have all of that there. And this almost serves as a useful pin section. So I'm using reminders a heck of a lot more. Now, in terms of my work setup, for those who don't know, I keep things pretty rigid inside of Evernote. So I send everything into an inbox, and from there I do a weekly inbox refresh. Notebooks don't get refreshed that often. I tend to refresh my notebooks section about every 6 months, and I'm actually due one very soon. And that is literally a 15-minute process in going, does this notebook belong in this stack? And then I can go brutally, okay, no, it doesn't. So I will move it to another stack. And it provides me with just with a bit of a spring clean, I guess. So that's an every 6 month item. Now, I do use Evernote quite a lot. I would say mainly agendas. I use it quite a lot because I really love the sharing function. For those who don't know, you can share a shareable link straight away, and that provides me with the best. But recently I've been using the new table functionality on Mac, and they have also released this on other platforms quite a bit. So I'm going to demonstrate what I have been using it for. So for example, as you can see here, this is the wedding payments that I've got coming up for our wedding in June. And it's obviously useful to know what's coming up. It's almost like a pipeline. And that's what I've created quite a lot recently, is this sort of pipeline setup. And I've actually been able to have quite a good time with it, quite a positive time with it. And we've done it with a lot of actually different stuff in the wedding too. But you can see here, I've got a time and date, and the amount I'm spending on it, and whether it's paid so far. And this way, I can actually tally this off. And it's sort of an extended one here, because I can see all of the information on the wedding so far. And I can sort of go, okay, I can update this using the status tab inside of the column. So using the table area has actually really revolutionized my own Evernote setup. Now, the one thing that it was before is pretty not so good. And Evernote have made a lot of movements on this. I specifically like the ability to add colors. So for example, I want to color that entire cell area, then I could cell background it, and I could even distribute the columns in a different fashion as well. So it's pretty beautifully designed. So they've done a really good job on that, and it's probably something I've been properly using recently. The next thing I've been doing as well is emailing in and BCCing my Evernote custom email quite a lot. So I've actually been using it to send in certain items with attachments or items that I need for projects and referencing, and then using the inbox to actually put them in the specific notebook. And this has been a huge area. So for those who don't know, you find your customer Evernote email inside of account settings, and that just provides you with so much. Now, some of the things I'm improving, as I said, the notebook refresh I need to do 6 months spring clean, change all of that up. I need to re-look into tags. It's sort of like filters to some extent in Todoist. I know the abilities and the functionality are there, but I struggle to implement such a structure. So it's something that I'm continually working on. And finally, the ability to send into Evernote. I did a feature on how to, the four sort of things that you can use. You can add tags, reminders, etc. But for me, I actually haven't been using this in the speed of which I'm sending them. I tend to forget about it. So actually refreshing my own knowledge of that and keeping it up is a very important thing on my list. So guys, that was a general overview of my Evernote setup. Just before I leave, I wanted to share my insights into the new Evernote Spaces for Business. Now, I've been in touch with the team, and they've shared, obviously, the Spaces section with me. And of course, it's an official announcement as well. So basically, Spaces is an area inside of Evernote Business that you can now, well, actually, it's almost released. It basically brings together like a dashboard for your team instead of having like a bit of a recent notes and that's it. You can now basically pin notes for your team and be able to access this mini dashboard of recent notes and any activity log changes anybody have ever made, which is quite interesting. So it's almost like just having your Evernote account on view to some extent for your own team, but they are releasing this for personal users, so that's quite interesting. I'm going to include the video that they launch with it in the description below, because that always visualizes everything in such a good way, and I'll include all of the information, including the blog post launch, in there too. So hopefully you'll get all of the insights you need, but my opinion of it, of Spaces, I think that will probably revolutionize some people's Evernote accounts. I think they're falling slacking in some of the space, because the likes of Notion I believe it's Coda as well, are making moves in the flexible application space. And I think they're doing it with a bit with tables and things like that. But actually the ability to modify your own and pin and like, create your own setup is something that Evernote is really only done for the advanced users. And I think they're going to slowly break down that gap. Anyway, guys, I hope that you enjoyed my setup video. I hope it gave you a nice overview of how I use Evernote in my daily routine. Again, as you can see, very simplistic. I'll include the video I did before of it, although people did complain of the loud music, which I really did have poorly loud music last time. So I really do apologize, but I'll make sure to make that one available in the description below. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Hopefully this was useful. Let me know in the comments below whether you recommend any tag setups for me or anything like that. I'll be more than happy to check out. And also whether you have any Evernote setup tips for me. Anyway, guys, thank you so much for stopping by. Make sure to have a great week. Keep productive. And I'll see you guys very, very soon. Cheers.